Hello and welcome to Your Actives EU Tweets of the Week. This week, COP26 drops a clanger, shark mascot is an absolute banger, and Olaf Scholz has a surprising doppelganger. This episode is supported by CESAR, the mechanism that coordinates EU R&D in air traffic management. More about them later on. COP26 wrapped up last Friday, and we're all going to be dealing with the fallout for at least a decade. General consensus? Not good. When Boris Johnson says the COP26 deal is a game-changing agreement, he means it's gone from risk to cards against humanity, right? Asked Tiernan Dulib. Not a Cluedo, more like, replied Paul Bennett. The talks crawled on interminably, but little was actually agreed. Le Chou reported that as the COP26 talks dragged on, Frans Timmermans' beard reached record bushiness. Industrial Europe described the Glasgow Climate Pact as half-hearted, but said union calls for a real just transition will only grow in volume. But Marina Purkis summed it up best. So there was a big event to agree how to stop killing the planet, and all they agreed was to keep killing the planet, but just a tiny bit slower. In cheerier news, the EU institutions were awash with cute and huh this week. In a new communications push, the EU used an adorable robot to explain the difference between the Council of the EU, European Council and the Council of Europe. If it could do that, it would definitely fail the Turing test, said DG Meme. We're too often criticised for being faceless bureaucrats. This won't help, remarked Piotr Chiszkowski. Elsewhere, the Greens in the European Parliament rolled out a shark mascot as part of a campaign to protect Mako sharks. Tom Asensted said he was awestruck at meeting Sammy Shark. Personally, I reckon he looks more terrified. And Sammy certainly got around. Though I'm not entirely sure why a shark is carrying a laptop bag. That said, an MEP making a probably knowing meta reference to the TV show Parliament, we are all duty bound to like. This week we are supported by CESAR, the mechanism that coordinates EU R&D in air traffic management. Find out more about digital transformation, smart airports and the award-winning Aeroporti di Roma by following them online. Finally this week, do not adjust your screen. No, you don't need to go to Specsavers. These really are two different people. Specifically, German Vice Chancellor Olaf Scholz and US Senator Chris Coons. Absolutely refuse to believe these are two different people, said Mac Chick. All whites look the same, snarked Andres Hernandez. Counterpart is real, tweeted Frederic Moreau. Bonus points, sir, for the niche sci-fi TV reference. Shared values and shared face, suggested Frank Bow. But Tom Nuttall has nothing but respect for them just going ahead and publishing this picture. Fair point. And that's it for another Tweets of the Week. Join me again next Friday for more snarks and larks in the Brussels bubble Twittersphere.